वेलकम टू द वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ थियोरी ऑफ कंप्यूटेशन. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट इंटरफे टू डीएफए कन्वर्जन. आई एम योर इंस्ट्रक्टर पूनम पटेल. लेट स्टार्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड टुडेज लेक्चर. वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इंट्रोडक्शन. द फर्स्ट वन इज इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट एनएफए मेथड. द नेक्स्ट इज एग्जाम्पल हाउ वी कैन कन्वर्ट द एनएफए टू डीएफए बाय यूजिंग द एग्जाम्पल वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड. नाउ स्टार्ट विद द method. Okay, so first of all we need to understand what is NFA. In a previous video we are already know what is NFA. So NFA is non-deterministic finite automata. So in NFA there are two main cases occur. It may be happen for a given input there are multiple transition may occur in NFA, and the second there is no transition for a given input symbol. Okay, now next is let us understand NFA by using the example which is we have already discussed in a previous video. So here you can see in this NFA diagram, this diagram is for the regular expression 0 plus 1 star dot 0. It means that this NFA is defined for the strings which ends with 0. Okay, so this NFA accepting the string which ends with the 0. If you see in this NFA there is a 0 on a state A. For a 0 input symbol it moves two states, one is A and another one is B. So for a given input symbol on a A state it moves more than one state. So we can say that this diagram is giving it is a non-deterministic finite automata. Okay, if you see on a B state there is no any transition for a given input symbol 0 and 1. So there is no transition for the 0 1 input symbol. So in NFA there may be a transition for the given input symbol and there may be a more than one transition for the given input symbol. Okay, so let's start to understand how we can convert the NFA to DFA. Now first of all there are multiple methods available which are used to conversion from the NFA to DFA. Here we are going to use the subset construction method. As the name suggests, subset construction method which we are going to use as a subset. We are going to construct this subset. Okay, so these are the following steps which we have to follow. The first step said that start with the initial state in the NFA and determine all the reachable state for the initial state for every input symbol. So, and second number step, the set of reachable state constitute is considered as a single state. So, step number one said that we have to find out what are the reachable state from the initial state, and this all reachable state are considered as a single state. The next one is find out the reachable state for the each new DFA state until no more new state can be found. Now let us understand this concept, this methods by using the example. So here they said that we have to convert the given NFA to DFA. Okay, so this is the figure they had given and they said that this is NFA figure and we need to convert in a DFA. As we know in DFA what are the two main condition which occur in DFA. The first condition is said that in DFA for every input symbol from every state we need to show the transition, and the second condition said that for every input symbol there is exist only one specific path. It means that for a given input symbol from a given state we need to move only one state, not more than one state. Okay, so by using the subset construction we can convert the NFA to DFA. Now start with the step number one, how we can convert. So step number one said that we need to first of all, if state transition diagram is given for a NFA we need to convert it in a transition table for a NFA. So as we already know how to construct the transition table, contain two main things. The first is current state, the next is next state, like this you can see over here. Okay, now you can see there are two state in our diagram. The first is A, the second is B. Now A is our initial state and B is our final state. Now A this next column in a transition table for a 0 input symbol, which next state it moves, for a input symbol 1, which next state it moves. So A on 0, by using the diagram, you can see A on 0, A from A state getting 0, which state we can move? We can move 2 state, A, B. Now A on 0, see the figure, A on 1, which state it moves? It stay in the same state, which is A, so we have to write down A. Okay, same here, we have to complete the row for the B state. So B is our final state, so that's why I have put the stars. Now B on 0, there is nothing transition, there is no transition show on a B state for a 0 input symbol, so we need to mention it as a 5. If there is no transition, we have to mention the 5. Same here, B on 1, there is no any transition on a B state for a 1 input symbol, we need to specify 5. 5 indicating there is no transition on a NFA, okay. Now this is the first step. So what is the first step? First of all, we need to construct the transition table for a NFA. Now step number 2. Step number 2 said that we are trying to construct the all reachable state from the initial state and consider this reachable state as a new DFA state. So here we are going to try construct the transition table for the deterministic finite automata. How we are going to construct the transition table? So as we know, transition table contain two main things. One is input symbol, which define the next state from which where we can move, and the current state at where we are. Okay, so start with the initial state. So by using the transition table of NFA, we are constructing the transition table for the DFA. Now first row is same in a DFA by using the NFA. So first row like this, start with the initial state A on 0, which state we are going to move? So there are two state, A, B. So I have write down A, B. Now A on 0, which state it moves? It moves only one state, which is E. Okay, so this first row is same in a both the transition table, always remember. But now onwards in a DFA, what are the new state we are going to take in a DFA? So always remember, the next state which are generated by using the initial state for the given input symbol is our new initials, a new state for the DFA. So there are two new state is generated. The first state, the name is A comma B. So A comma B is our state, and the next is A state. Okay, so A state we have already declared in a row. Now we have generated a state, new state A comma B. So our second row is fill up for the new state. So our new state on getting 0, where it moves, a new state on getting 1, where it moves. So here A comma B on getting 0. So both the transition we need to combine it like this, delta A comma 0 union delta B comma 0, and both the state we need to combine it. Okay, so A on 0, see the transition table of NFA, A on 0, where it moves? A comma B. B on 0 is 5. So A comma B union 5 is A comma B. So we need to mention A comma B like this. Okay, like this. Delta A B comma 0. So delta A comma 0 union delta B comma 0. So A comma 0 moves state A comma B union 5. So it moves the state A B union 5. It means that A B. So here our answer is for the input symbol 0 is A comma B. Now for a input symbol 1, A comma B. So here you can see delta A comma 1 union B comma 1. So from a state A on a getting 1, which state it moves? It moves A. And B from a state B on a getting 1, from where we moves, there is no any transition for a input symbol 1 on a B state, so we need to specify as a 5, A union 5 is A. So here A. Now check, is there any new state is created which is not mentioned in a current state? No, there is no any new state which are not mentioned in current state. If you see no new state, the one state is A and the next state is A comma B. So this both state we have to mention over here, and this is the last step for the DFA. Now it means that our transition table is complete. Okay, so if you remember the third step we have discussed, there is no more state is occur. The last step is we have to create a new state until no more new state is fine. Okay, so here we have created the transition table for the DFA, and then by using this DFA table, we can convert this table into the state transition diagram of DFA, which is very simple. We have already discussed about this. So here you can see this is. Draw the DFA by using the transition table of DFA here. Okay, so there are two states we have to create it. A comma B, only two states. Okay, so current state row you have to check it. So this many state we have to create it. So there are two state, A, which is our initial state, A comma B. If you see in NFA, B is our accepting state. So in a DFA, where the state which contain B are the accepting state for the DFA. So here AB, A comma B, our new state, which is a final state. Now complete the transition. So on A state getting 0 from where it moves, A comma B. So here A on 1 from where it moves the same state A. Now A comma B on getting 0, it moves the same state A comma B. A comma B, AB state on getting 1 from where it moves the A state. Okay. So this is the final step for final step to construct the DFA for the given NFA. So I hope this concept is clear to you. Thank you all.